Intra-workout protein. Hurting your gains, harmful, what is it? This has to stop. We gotta fix this based on my own lab research. The experience starts right now. What is going on? My name is David Barr. If you're looking to get bigger, faster, stronger, get leaner, go longer, hit that subscribe and then the little bell so you don't miss out latest tips and tricks. Today, quick and dirty FAQ about protein during your workout, intra-workout protein. Doesn't matter if it's amino acids, protein, same thing, same concept, probably hurting your gains because your body does not care about the protein during the workout. Yeah, you don't want to be protein fasted, but the key is you want to have changes in your blood protein levels, your blood amino acid levels. That's what your body is going to detect, and that is what is going to stimulate what is called muscle protein synthesis. I learned this one the hard way in the lab. The body responds to changes, increases more specifically in blood amino acids. So this is cool. We can take advantage of this. It's called protein pulse feeding. I talk about this in my first two books called The Anabolic Index. Pulsing your protein is going to increase your blood amino acid levels if you're consuming a fast absorbing protein like a whey or something like that. The key is you have to be fasted to do it. So you can think of intra-workout protein, a flatlined protein. Think of flatline as the death of protein synthesis. And yes, that is totally hyperbolic, but I think it gets the concept across. It's not really harmful like to your kidneys or anything like that. I mean, too much protein, no. But it's not going to be optimal for gains. For that, you want to pulse your protein, have increases and then slight decreases in your blood amino acid levels, and that's going to get you that maximum anabolic response. Now, overnight, yes, you want a flat line of amino acids because you don't want to be protein fasted, right? That's key. Super anabolic. A lot of people miss out on this. Think of sleep as our most anabolic time. It's typically our most catabolic time. Talk about that in another video. If you haven't seen that one of my more popular videos, about three tips on casein, check that one out. Do not miss that one. That is key. Real quick, I want to hear from you. When are you consuming your protein? Is it before your workout, after your workout, even during your workout? Let me know in the comments below. Now, the other trick to this is if you're consuming protein during your workout, you're not getting the full benefit of crit loading. Crit loading is going to be optimizing your CNS, optimizing your protein synthesis for your actual gains, whether it's strength, muscle growth, even fat loss, whatever it is you want to do this crit loading. I talk about that in other videos. I'll link to the creatine video, some of my research with NASA at the Johnson Space Center, some of my research with the radioactive poison, very cool stuff. Check that one out. It was my first video and my relaunch of my channel post muscle and fitness, but check that one out. It's very cool. You do not want to miss that. So there's two reasons you don't want to be using protein intra workout. Don't do it. You can do it before, you could do it after, whatever it is, but intra workout just doesn't matter. It's not a big deal. Now, if you like it, cool, do it. Not telling you not to do it, just suboptimal. That's the key. So if you're looking to optimize your gains, you don't want to do this. Until next time, raise the bar.